welcome everybody to know all about nanoscience and technology. In today's video, we'll be studying yet another method for synthesis of nanomaterials, which is hydrothermal method. So here the name hydrothermal itself indicates that the process involves hydro, that is water, and thermal, that is heat or temperature. It is one of the most commonly used methods for preparation of nanomaterials. It is basically a solution reaction based approach. So let's dive in and know more in detail about this hydrothermal method. Firstly, let's understand the definition. The term hydrothermal is defined as performing chemical reactions in solvents contained in sealed vessels in which the temperature of solvents can be brought to around their critical points via heating concurrently with autogenous pressures. So this definition explains that this method involves chemical reactions that take place in solvents placed in sealed vessels at high temperature. The process is referred to as hydrothermal because in this method water is used as the solvent. Then if we make use of any other solvent other than water, then the method will be called as solvothermal. Now in this case, we make use of water as the solvent. That's why the process is named as hydrothermal. Hydrothermal synthesis refers to the heterogeneous reactions for synthesizing inorganic materials in aqueous media about ambient temperature and pressure. That means this method involves synthesis of materials at higher temperature and pressure. In this case, an aqueous mixture of precursors is heated in a sealed stainless steel autoclave above the boiling point of water, and consequently the pressure within the reaction autoclave is dramatically increased above atmospheric pressure. So here what we do is we place a reaction mixture in a closed stainless steel container and heat it above the boiling point of water. And this causes the pressure inside the closed container to increase above the atmospheric pressure. Okay? So this synergetic effect of high temperature and pressure provides one-step process to produce highly crystalline materials without the need of post-annealing treatments. This technique becomes useful when it is difficult to dissolve the precursors at low temperatures and room temperature or room temperature. Because this method involves the use of high temperature, it is beneficial to dissolve the precursors which are otherwise unable to dissolve at low temperatures or at room temperature. Then this technique proves to be useful to grow nanoparticles if the material has a high vapor pressure near its melting point or crystalline phases are not stable at melting point. In hydrothermal synthesis, the formation of nanomaterials can happen in a wide temperature range from room temperature to very high temperatures. To control the morphology of the materials to be prepared, either low pressure or high pressure conditions can be used depending on the vapor pressure of the main composition in the reaction. That means we can control the morphology of synthesized methods by either using low pressure conditions or high pressure conditions depending on the vapor pressure of the main composition in the reaction. Now let's have a look at its instrumentation part. The hydrothermal process is carried in a sealed reactor known as autoclave, a pressure vessel or a high pressure bomb. That means the vessel or the container in which the reactions of the reaction mixture take place is called as autoclave. It is specific style of strong vessel that we intend to face up to high temperatures and better pressure levels from within. That means it can this particular autoclave can withstand high temperature and pressure. The autoclave consists of thick and steel walled cylindrical vessels having hermetic sealing, which helps it to bear high levels of heat and pressure regularly and safely for a long time. Now here the hermetic means complete sealing or airtight. So this autoclave consists high and thick coatings so that it is able to withstand high temperature and pressure. Mostly hydrothermal reactors are metal autoclaves with Teflon or alloy linings or containing an extra beaker or tube made of Teflon, platinum, gold or silver to protect the autoclave body from the highly corrosive solvent which is held at high temperature and pressure. An ideal hydrothermal autoclave should be leak proof and possess sufficient running life within the experimental temperature and pressure range. Temperature, pressure and corrosive resistance of reactor materials are the most important parameters for the reactor selection. Now this was all about its instrumentation. Now let's understand the mechanism of crystal growth by hydrothermal process. Synthesis of nanomaterials by hydrothermal method is a crystallization process directly from solutions that usually involve two steps, that is crystal nucleation and subsequent growth. Nucleation occurs when the solubility of the solute exceeds its limit in the solution, that is when the solution becomes supersaturated. This reaction is irreversible. The solute precipitates into clusters of crystals that can grow to macroscopic size. Then following nucleation, the crystals grow sequentially or concurrently via a series of processes involving the incorporation of growth units which have the same composition as crystal entities but possess the same or different structures from the bulk solution into existing crystal entities and causing increased sizes. These different processes can be roughly categorized into four steps, that is transport of units through solution, attachment of units to surface, movement of units on surface and attachment of units to growth sites. So the whole mechanism of this hydrothermal method can be explained with the help of this diagram. As you can see, firstly we have our solute molecules. Now when this solution becomes supersaturated, that is the solutes in the solution no longer dissolve in it, is the point where nucleation takes place. Nucleation is nothing but formation of nuclei via self-assembly or self-organization. Now after the nucleation, these nuclei precipitate in the solution and there is involvement of growth units. These growth units have same composition as the crystal entities but they may differ in the structure. Further, these growth units get incorporated into existing crystal which increases the size of the crystals. In this way, there is a growth of these crystals and ultimately we gain our prepared nanomaterials. Now I hope you guys must be clear about how nanomaterials are synthesized using hydrothermal method. So this was all about its instrumentation part and mechanism. So nextly we'll see about its advantages and disadvantages. Firstly, let's read out its advantages. Hydrothermal synthesis can generate nanomaterials which are not stable at elevated temperatures. Next, nanomaterials with high vapor pressures can be produced with minimum loss of materials. That means this method is cost effective. It also creates larger sized and high quality crystals and nanoparticles. A major advantage of this method is that it can be hybridized with other processes like microwave, electrochemistry, ultrasound, mechanochemistry, optical radiation and hot pressing to gain advantages such as enhancement of reaction kinetics and increased ability to make new materials. And lastly, also these methods are more environment friendly. Now, let's have a look at its disadvantages. There are no more disadvantages. The only disadvantage is that the high cost of equipment. The autoclave that we use in this method is highly costly. So this is the only disadvantage of this method. Okay then, with this we are done studying hydrothermal method, and I hope you guys found it easy and helpful. So if you did, then do hit the like button and share it with them who would also find it helpful. Also, don't forget to subscribe this channel if you are willing to study more such interesting concepts related to nanoscience and technology. So now it's time to end, but until next time, be happy and keep learning.